Well, it's a great pleasure for us and Google to be here today. And I must say it's been terrific fun putting together this project with the ladies and gentlemen from the Leo team. And it's not very often that you have the opportunity to spend time with pioneers who have created something new and changed an entire industry. And I think it's not an exaggeration to say that the Leo team did that. And I must say, when I first heard about Leo, I kind of had to check the date to make sure it wasn't anything the first. I had no inkling at all that the first business computer had been invented or put into practice by a chain of tea shops in Britain. And you know, as I think Time magazine said recently, it was a little bit like being told that McDonald's had invented the internet. But the scale, I think, of the achievement is extraordinary, because I think today we take computing in business completely for granted. Every single business in the country has a computer. But back then, by no means something that was evident or obvious. So the Economist in 1954, for example, wrote, "There are those who do not believe and the desirability of introducing anything as esoteric as electronics into business routine. Others believe there is a limited field for electronic methods, provided they do not disrupt established business systems." It was ever thus, wasn't it? But I think what was particularly revolutionary about Leo was that until that point, the use of business machines were to do particular tasks within a business. And really the achievement of Leo was to bring everything together in one machine that could handle whole swathes of lines business right across the board. So in that sense, I think the achievement of Leo is something that all modern businesses owe a great debt of gratitude to the people who worked on this team. So as Frank says, we have put together a little film. The aim of this, I think it's important to make this point, that this isn't just about nostalgia. It's wonderful to be here today, and it's a very nostalgic meeting and great to see the team come back together and reminisce. But I think our involvement in this is not so much to do with nostalgia. When Eric Schmidt spoke about the Leo computer in his speech in Edinburgh in the summer, the point he wanted to make was that fantastic computing and technology heritage that once existed in Britain sadly no longer exists. So I think our aim in really putting together this film is to hope that this story, this amazing story, gets a wider audience and perhaps will inspire the next generation of computer science and scientists to do pioneering achievements in the same vein. So I'll run to the machine and switch on the film.